never been there. Well, perhaps once, but I was so engulfed in the OE I never made it to the dope. You speak of hardcore. Why the DJ sweating out all the problems and troubles of the day? Why this fine bow-legged girl harness all I doze? Loves lukewarm lullabies in your left ear, competing with set it off in the right. But it all blends perfectly. Let the liquor tell it. Hey, hey, look, baby, they playing our song. And the crowd goes wild as if Holyfield just won the fight. But in actuality, it's only about 3 a.m. And three niggas just done got hauled off in the ambulance. Two niggas done started busting. One nigga done took his shirt off, talking about, now who else wanna fuck with Hollywood Cole? Other situation.
Yesterday, the way she moved reminded me of a brown stallion horse with skates on, you know, smooth like a hot comb on nap ass hip. I walked up on her and was almost paralyzed. Her neck was smelling sweeter than a plate of yams with extra syrup. Eyes beaming like 4 carats of peach, just blinding the nigga. Felt like I cheated the whole order at presidential. My heart would beat so damn fast. Never knowing this moment would bring another life into this world. Funny how shit comes together sometimes, you dig? One moment you frequent the booty clubs, and the next 4 years you and somebody's daughter raising your own youngin'. Now that's a beautiful thing. That's if you're on top of your game and man enough to handle real life situations, that is. Can't gamble feeding baby on that dope money. Might not always be sufficient. But the United Parcel Service and the people at the post office didn't call you back because you had clout and piss. So now you back in the trap. Just that. Trap. Go on and marinate on that for a minute.
Jack, 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 J